Today we are going to learn two more concepts in our third chapter, divisibility. Till now in divisibility we have seen many concepts like divisibility test, types of numbers. In that we have seen even numbers, odd numbers, prime numbers, composite numbers, right? After that we have seen prime factors or prime divisors. Okay, divisors, multiples, we have seen then prime factors. Also we have seen common divisors, right? After these concepts, the next two concepts which today we are going to learn, they are based on the previous concepts. Okay, so the first concept which we are going to learn today is GCD. GCD means what, or what is meant by GCD, and how it is related with the multiples and factors. Okay, see, GCD, the meaning of GCD, full form of GCD is greatest common divisor. Greatest common divisor. Okay, first we'll talk about GCD, later we'll talk about this LCM. Greatest, G for greatest, C for common, and D for divisors. See, GCD means greatest common divisors. Sometimes here instead of G we can use H also. H, C, and for D we can use F also. Why? Because D means divisor and it is also called factor. G for greatest and it can be also called highest. Highest common factor. So GCD or HCF, same. Okay, greatest common divisor or highest common factor, same. So what is meaning of this? See here, we know divisors or factors. Divisors or factors we know, right? We have learned this concept, divisors or factors. Divisors or factors means what? The numbers, for example, if there is 12, then its divisors are, means such numbers by which 12 is divisible, right? Or such numbers in which table there is 12, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. See, in these are the divisors of 12. These are the divisors of 12. Okay, so divisors or factors. These are the divisors or factors of 12. Also, we have learned about common divisors or common factors. We have learned this concept, common divisors or common factors. Common divisors or common factors. This concept is related with two numbers. When there is 15, suppose there is 12 and 15, and factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5 and 15 itself. Okay, so out of between these two numbers, between the factors of these two numbers, which factors are common? Common means the numbers which are factors of 15 as well as 12. So which factors are common? 1, correct? Then there is 3, this much. So between 15 and 12, 1 and 3 are the common divisors or common factors. Understood? Common divisors, common factors. Now the one word is remaining, greatest and highest or highest. Highest means only greatest, okay? So greatest means what? Greatest common divisors. See here, we have got common, which common divisors we have got here? 1 and 3. So in these common divisors, which one is greater? Which one is greater? 3, right? 3 is greater. So GCD of 12 and 15 is 3. Means greatest common divisor of 12 and 15 is 3. Understood? This is the concept of GCD. See here. Now understood the meaning of each word which are included in the GCD. GCD means greatest common divisor. Greatest common divisors. Okay, so here I'll show you an example of GCDC. We'll tell you 32 and 48. Okay. Now you know 32 are 32 is in which table? 1. Again, it is divisible by 2 also, as last digit is 2. Then is it divisible by 3? 3 plus 2, 5. No. Is it divisible by 4? Yes, 4 8 is 32. 5 no, 6 no, see 8. 8 4 is 32, correct? Then it is divisible by 16 and 32 itself. Then 48. 48 is divisible by 1. Last digit is 8, so it is divisible by 2 also. Then it is divisible by 8 plus 4. 8 plus 4, 12. That means it is divisible by 3 also. 4 also. 6 also. 6 8 is 48. 8 also. 8 6 is 48. Right? Then 4, 12, 4, oh, sorry. 12, 4 is 48. 6, 3 is 16, 3 is 48. 24, 2 is 48. And 48, 1 is 48. Okay, so these are the factors or divisors of 32, and these are the divisors of 48. Now, once we have found divisors, now we will find common divisors. So, in these, which are common divisors? Yes. 1, 2, 4, 8. Correct? 16. Finish. So, common divisors are 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. These are the common divisors of 32 and 48. Okay, means these are the divisors of 32 as well as 48. Now, GCD means what? GCD means what? GCD of 32 and 48. GCD of 32 and 48 is, GCD means greatest common divisor. We first found divisors, then we found common divisors. Now in these common divisors, which is greatest, that we have to write here, that is GCD. Greatest common divisor. So in these common divisors, which is greatest, biggest, highest, 16, right? So 16 is the GCD or HCF, GCD or HCF of 32 and 48. So answer is 16. Understood? So basically, greatest common divisor GCD. This concept is related with the factors or divisors. Okay. Where opposite of it there is LCM. Now LCM, what is full form of LCM? Least common multiple or lowest common multiple. Least or lowest? Lowest common multiple. Greatest, lowest, common, same, and here divisor, here multiple. So this concept is related with the multiple. Here LCM, L stands for lowest, C for common, M for multiple. Okay. So this LCF or GCD and LCM, these are two exactly opposite concepts. Understood? One is related with factors or divisors. And the next one is LCM is related with the multiples. There we have to find greatest factor, here we have to find lowest multiple, smallest multiple. Understood? So let's do it. Suppose here we have to find LCM of 12 and 15. 12 and 15. Okay. Find LCM of 12 and 15. So here see, as this here we have to find greatest divisor, greatest common divisor. So we wrote here divisors. Here we want to find lowest common multiple. So we write multiples. Now multiples means what again? We have seen multiples means what? The numbers which are divisible by this given number 12 and 15, or the numbers which are in table of 12 and 15. Okay, they are multiples of 12 and the multiples of 15. So the numbers which are in table of 12 are 12 and the 12, 12 2s are 24, 12 3s are 36, 48, 60, 72, 84, 96, and so on. Whereas multiples of 15 are 51s are 15, 2s are 30, 3s are 45, then there is 60, 75, 90, then there is 105, 120, 135, and so on. There will increase 108, 120, and so on. Okay. Now this, the number of multiples are uncountable, so we cannot write all multiples because they are uncountable, whereas factors are limited. So we can write all factors and we will get highest factor, highest common factor. But multiples are uncountable, so we can write only limited. Okay, and here we want smallest multiple, so not need to write all multiples as it's not possible also. Now see, in these multiples, which are common multiples? First we have written multiples of 12, multiples of 15. Now let's move towards common multiples. Okay. Now which are common multiples here? 60. 60 is here also, in 60 is multiple of 12. And it is multiple of 15 also. Then there is 120. See, 60, 120. I have told you previously. We are getting common multiples in the pattern. See, 60, 62s are 120. Then we get 63s are 180. 64s are likewise. Okay, 240s are in this way. So common multiples we have got 60 and 120. There will be so many common multiples, but we need not. We don't want that, because see, we want now lowest common multiple, smallest. So LCM of 12 and 15 is LCM. So in this common multiples, which is smallest one, which is smallest or lowest? 60, right? So LCM of 12 and 15 is 60. LCM of 12 and 15 is 60. LCM is what? The number which is in table of 12 also and 15 also, right? It is smallest. The smallest number or lowest number which is in table of 12 and 15, or both given numbers. Okay? So this is the 60 is the smallest number or lowest number which is in table of 12 as well as 15. It is called LCM, and LCM means the highest common factor, highest divisor by which both the given numbers are divisible. Means 16. Here, 16 is the highest number, greatest number by which both 32 and 48 are divisible. 16 2s are 32, 16 3s are 48. Understood? So this is the concept of GCD or HCF and LCM. Understood? Okay. Now pause this video, write this in your notebook. See now, from exercise 6, we have learned questions, or we have solved questions till 20, right? The next questions, instruction for next example or question is, find the GCD of following numbers. Find the GCD of following numbers. GCD means HCF, highest common factor or greatest common divisor. Say, okay? So see, here we have to find GCD of the given two numbers. For this, we are going to use prime factorization method. Which method? Prime factorization method. Now for the Ganit Pravinya, they have not suggested specific method. There are so many methods like prime factorization method, short division method, long division method to find HCF and LCM. But they have not suggested any method. We can use any method. So the easiest method we are going to use prime factorization method. Okay, for our regular maths, we are going to learn two methods, prime factorization and short division method. So here in Ganit Pravinya, we are going to use only one method, prime factorization method. Okay, already in fourth standard, we have learned this. So when I will explain you, you will come to know. Okay, so see, find the GCD of following numbers. Example number 21, refer the Xerox which I have given you or the PDF which I have sent you on the WhatsApp for this exercise 6. Okay. Example number 21 is 12. Find the GCD of following numbers 12 and 18. So here we have to find greatest common divisor of 12 and 18. Okay. So which method we are going to use to find GCD here? Prime factorization method. Now see, prime factorization. If you remember, we have learned to find prime factors of the given number. Do you remember? I have given one video of that lecture, prime factors, right? So we have learned to find prime factors. Same, first we have to find prime factors of 12, then we have to find prime factors of 18. Okay? And on the next steps, I'll show you. So first we need to find prime factors of 12. And when we find prime factors, what we do? Yes, we write number this way. Now we know we have prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19 and so on. Okay. Now see. First we will check 12 is divisible by which prime number. Is it divisible by our first prime number 2? Yes. Now here to check whether it is divisible by these prime numbers, we need to use divisibility test. Okay. So last digit of 12 is 2, that means it is divisible by 2. So write 2 here, 12 divided by 2, 2, 6 are 12. 2, 6 are 12, okay? Then, again check, 6 is divisible by our first number, is 6 divisible by our first number, our first prime number 2? Yes, 2, 3 are 6. And 3 is divisible by which prime number? 3 is prime number itself, so it is divisible by itself. 3, 1, 3. Finish. So these are the prime factors of 12. Then find prime factors of 18. Again, 18, is 18 divisible by our first prime number? Yes. As last digit is 8, it is divisible by 2. 2, 9s are 18, okay? The 9 is divisible by which prime number? Is it divisible by our first prime number 2? No. It is divisible by 3. 3 threes are 9 and 3 ones are 3. Okay. So here, the first step we have completed, we have found prime factors of both the numbers, prime factors of 12 and prime factors of 18. Now the next step, please pay attention carefully or see the steps. And understand it. See, here we have found prime factors of 12, write 12 here and is equal to 12 is equal to write all prime factors. Whenever we write prime factors, if you remember, whenever we write prime factors, write them in the form of multiplication. That is 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, so these are the prime factors of 12. After that, here below 12. Write prime factors of 18. So prime factors of 18 are 2 into 3 into 3. So 2 into 3 into 3. Okay? Understood second step. First we found prime factors in this way and then we wrote prime factors of both the numbers in this way. The next step is very important. See, what we have to do, In this prime factors of 12 and 18, which are common prime factors? Now, common means, you know, common means what? The factor of this also, prime factors of 12 also, prime factors of 18 also, it should be. So, see, this 2 and 2 is common, 2 and 2 is common. So, we will circle it, we will circle it, okay? Then, which is common? This 2 and 3, are these common? No. 3 and 3 are common. 3 is here also, 3 is in this also. So, take it common. Understood this step? We have taken common factor. We have circled common factor. Okay? Now, GCD. GCD. Of 12 and 15 is equal to GCD of 12 and 15 is means what? Multiplication of common factors. Multiplication of common factors. In according to this method, what we have to do? We have to multiply common factors. Only multiplication of common factors. Right? Multiplication of common factors. Okay, multiplication of common factors. So, which are common factors here? Common prime factors 2 and 3. Now, see, we have circled this 2, this 2, and this 2. We have to take it only one time. 2, which this is one common factor 2, and this is second another common factor 3. So, 2 into 3. That is 6. So our answer is 6. 6 is the highest common factor or greatest common divisor of 12 and 18. Now you can check by see 6 6 is means 12 and 18 is divisible by 6, right? And it is the highest. More than 6 or greater than 6, there is not a number which is greater than 6. By which this 12 and 18 are divisible. Okay, there is no other greater number. 6 is the greater number or greater common divisor of greatest common divisor of 12 and 18. Understood? So this is the prime factorization method, and this we are going to use to find GCD as well as LCM also. Okay, for LCM also same method we are going to use. Just there is little change here. That I will tell you while finding LCM. Now see, let's find the HCF or GCD of 36 and 48. Same procedure we have to do. First find prime factors of 36. Now see, 36, last digit is 6, that means it is divisible by 2. 36 divided by 2, what else we will get? 36 divided by 2. If orally you are not able to find, then divide it. 2 ones are 2, 2 8 is 16. What we are getting? 18 2s are 36. So 36 divided by 2 is 18. Okay. Further, 18 is divisible by, see now, 18, prime factors of 18 are here. 2 9s are 18, 3 3s are 9, and 3 1s are 3. Finished. So these are the prime factors of 36. Let's find prime factors of 48. Now see, 48 is again last digit is 8, that means it is divisible by our first prime number 2. So let's divide 48 by 2. What answer do we get? 48 divided by 2? 2 2's are 4, 2 4's are 8. 24. 24 2's are 48, okay? Further, 24 is 24 divisible by 2? Yes. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. 12. Now prime factors of 12 are here. 2 6 are 12. 2 3s are 6. 3 1s are 3. Finish. First step over, we have found prime factors of 36 and 48. Okay. Now see, right here. Prime factors of 36 are 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, and prime factors of 48 are 2 into 2 into. Now see, these two we have written here, these two we have written here. Okay, now see upside. If you have seen in this first example, we have taken common factors, so we have to take common factors later. So what we are going to do, you know, upside there is 3, right? So what we will do in this prime factors of 48, is there 3? Yes, see this. So this 3 will write below this divide, then it is easy to take common factors. It becomes easy to take common factors. Okay, so this 3 we have written. We can change the order of numbers in the multiplication. Okay, so this 3 we have taken first. After that, is there one more 3? No. So remaining 2, we can write it. This arrangement we have done, order of numbers we have changed in the multiplication. Okay, it's okay. Now a common factor, common prime factors. See, this 2 and this 2 is common, so we will circle it. This 2 and this 2 common, it's not circle, it is box, we will say. This 3 and this 3 is common. Okay, so this 3, 2, they are not common. So common prime factors we have circled. Now you know GCD means what? GCD of 36 and 48 is equal to what? Multiplication of common factor or product of common factor. That is, which are common factors here? Common prime factors 2, 2 and 3. Okay, 2 into 2 into 3, that is 3 to the 6, 6 to the 12. So GCD, greatest common divisor, GCD of 36 and 48 is 12. 12 is the highest common factor or divisor of 36 and 48. Okay, see, 12 3 is 36, 12 4 is 48. Both numbers are divisible by 12. There is no greater number than 12 by which 36 and 48 is divisible. 12 is only the highest. Okay. And third one example we will see. 96 and 120. As we are going to find GCD using prime factorization method, so first we need to find prime factors of both the numbers. So prime factors of 96, is 96 divisible by 2? Yes, last digit is 6, that means it is divisible. Now divide 96 by 2. 2 4s are 8. 2 8s are 16. Answer is 48, okay? 48 2s are 96. There. 48 is divisible by, now see, be smart sometime. 48 C. Here we have to find prime factors of 48, and in this first example we have already found it. So let's write as it is. 2 24s are 48, 2 12s are 24, 2 6s are 12, 2 3s are 6, and 3 1s are 3. Okay, so these are the prime factors of 96. Then let's find prime factors of 120. Again, 120 is divisible by 12 because last digit is 0. Okay? So see, 120 divided by 2. 2 6 are 12 and 2 0 is 0, 60. Again, 60 is also divisible by 2. 2 3 is 6, 2 0 is 0. 30 to the 60. Then 30 is also divisible by 2. 2 15 is 15 to the 30. And 15 is divisible by, is 15 divisible by 2? No. The next prime number is 3. So check whether 15 is divisible by 3, 5 plus 1, 6, yes, 6 is there in the table of 3, that means 15 is divisible by 3, 3, 5 are 15, and 5 is divisible by 5 still, because it is prime number, okay, 5 is 5. So here are the prime factors of 96 and 120. Now, Let us write prime factors of 96. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Okay? Then prime factors of 120. Now see, there is 3 and we are in the prime factors of 96, 3 is here. Okay, so one change you can do, these 3 will write here and these 2 will write here. Okay, and these 3 right below this 3, and there is 5. There is no 5 in the prime factors of 96. Now take common factors. Make box to the common factors 2 and 2, 2 and 2, 2 and 2, and 3 and 3. See, sometimes what students do, they take common factors, you know, factors of 96 only, means these 2 and these 2, they will take common. No. Common means the factor should be the factor of 96 and 120. Understood? In this way only you have to take common factors. Now, GCD of 96 and 120 is. Now all that I keep not write multiplication of common factors. Once you understand, then you can directly write here. GCD of 96 and 120 is, you know, GCD means multiplication of common divisors, common factors, okay? So which are common here? 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Right? 2, 2, 2 and 3. So 3 to the 6, 6 to the 12, 12 to the 24. 24 is the GCD of 96 and 120. Understood? So these 3 examples of GCD we have solved today. What you have to do, remaining examples in this question. Example number C. Example number 24 and 25. Under this instruction, there are 5 examples, 21 to 25, okay? So, 3 examples you have taken here. You have to solve example number 24 and 25 today, okay? So, hope you have understood this. If you have any problem regarding with this, ask me, watch the video twice. If you once you not understand, then watch video twice. And even if you have any problem, you are free to ask, okay? So, thank you and have a nice day.